go try to ride Velocicoaster if it's open, but they close it for the
we've got a, what's it called?
Express Pass. We're going to see what we can do with the Express Pass today.
If you've ever been to Disney, it's like the old Fast Pass, which is gone. Except it's a lot better. And you get one of these.
Yeah, I don't know if it's better, but we're going to see how it works. We are wanting to ride Velocicoaster, but our daddy is, but it may be too cold because they shut it down when it's cold, and it's only about 40 degrees, so we will see. The Butterbeer line's pretty short. We're gonna go try and do Forbidden Journey though before the line gets long. Gonna put our backpack in the little backpack area up here over to the left. What'd you think of Spider-Man?
Spider-Man was cool. It was long. It was a long ride. We walked right on. There was no wait at all. It's really okay. Nice.
So yesterday Henry and I rode it, and then today they rode it again and no wait, so that was nice. And you both enjoyed it?
Yep.
All right, so we got in the early park hours. We got our express passes today. We're going to see how many we can ride. So it's a little after 9, and we have been on Spider-Man and Doctor Doom so far. We actually didn't need our express passes for either one of those. So we'll
Hulk
keep
counting.
Hulk isn't open yet. Velocicoaster had a long line that doesn't use express pass. So we're gonna go to Seuss Land and get some done there. But 2 down. Here we are in Seuss Land. We're gonna knock a couple out here. Here we are in Hagrid's. We got lucky and they said 45 minute wait. We hopped in line.
So,
yeah. So we got pretty lucky and just been moving along. It's pretty dark in here. I mean, that looks so much on the camera, but
don't just go right to the area.
Yeah, when you see the sign, that's where you get. You go part of the way through and they have a place for your locker. So be ready with your ticket to do your locker quickly. And you can jump in line faster. There were some really cool stuff as we were walking up to this part. We had to go going so fast we couldn't really even look at it because the line was intense. That was great. Maybe some other time.
Trouble is, if you start with Kennedy, it's okay though. I've got her in several boxes.
We just walked through kind of a cave-like hallway. We've been there for a while. And then we came into this room. Cool.
Looking for bar. The edible bar. You know what I mean?
So we were pretty excited. It was only 45 minute wait and we got on in 36. We were in there, the bars came down, and then the ride broke down. So now they put us in this little waiting area, so we're the first ones on. As soon as they get it going. Beach. And here's the little waiting area, just basically the beginning of the line. And they're running it through a few times. So now we are right at the 45-minute mark. We'll see how long this takes. So what do you think of Hagrid's?
Oh, it's crazy good, yeah.
Crazy good?
Yeah.
And after they fixed the ride, it was about 50 minutes to get on, so that wasn't too bad, and it was a lot of fun.
Yeah. It was cool. I would say 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
Area.
It's a pretty long ride, too, so that's nice.
Yeah, and the short rides, like the Hippogriff ride,
what's the white
which part? Is over there, it's really short. It's not waiting over 40 minutes.
Well, yeah, that's something like
that. No. I think that one's maybe made for young kids, but everyone rides it, so it gets pretty busy.
I thought it was,
Okay, now we're going to use our express pass on Forbidden Journey.
Yeah.
So we are getting in line for the Hogwarts Express. We're headed over to Universal. There's only a 10-minute wait, so we're not going to use our express pass right now. We'll save that for later, because we're going to come back for the light show on the castle. Now we're going to head to the Simpsons area, maybe eat some Krusty Burgers, ride the Simpsons ride, go from there. But this is nice, just a 10-minute basically walk on. So we haven't rode it this direction, so it should be fun.
Yeah.
So we found this nice little resting spot. Sun's out. High 60s. Not too crowded over here, so we took a break. I'll kind of close our eyes and lay in this little grassy area. Oh, felt good. Now we're gonna go use our express pass for Gringotts.
Okay, so today is over. Or not really. We're actually eating at this cool city walk place. I forgot what it was called.
Pat O'Brien's.
Yeah, Pat O'Brien's. Every place is full. Our low worker. And so anyways, the rides we were on today, Spider-Man, which we did twice, Almost Hulk, not ready for that one yet, Forbidden Journey, Hippogriff, Hagrid, Simpsons, Tron, or what was it that we...
Minions.
The Minions.
Transformers.
The Minions and Transformers, I don't like. I don't like the Minions. It's, you're in like a theater and you can see pretty much other people and a couch. And you're just going like this. The Transformers really bumpy.
The Jimmy Fallon.
The Jimmy Fallon.
Hogwarts Express twice.
Hogwarts Express twice.
You guys did the Dr. Seuss thing.
We did two Dr. Seuss.
We did two Dr. Seuss.
So that's 11. Any more, anybody?
Dad did Gringotts.
I did Gringotts, I did Velocicoaster.
And the Death Drop.
So I did 14 rides.
He did 14 rides. I didn't want to do the Velocicoaster. I don't think I'm tall enough for that.
We didn't do Gringotts because both of us had sore tummies after all the rides and the Butterbeer.
I was about to pass out. I needed water. So I could barely walk, so. And he did the Death Drop, but I looked at that and that's just waste of time. You drop once, but then you just kind of go like this. It's literally waste of time. But Spider-Man was really cool, especially the electrician part. I once again have to tell you, 3D rides are cool, but you don't want to do too many at a time.
It might be overdone here a little bit, like the...
Yeah, there's way too... Like, Spider-Man, I would kind of hope there's like a roller coaster for that, you know?
Yeah, I like Spider-Man. Transformers, I was...
I hate that.
I wouldn't say I hated it, but it was jerky, and it was kind of just the same stuff as Spider-Man, but not quite as good.
Yeah, the motorcycles. I want to tell you this. The lines are always going to be crazy on that. It's worth it. If you don't do it, then you're wasting. You don't know what you're doing. Now, if it's like 100 minutes, I can't blame you. Especially since you're going through Harry Potter land, and there's a bunch of people that just walk right in front of you. Like, anyways, Harry Potter land had a lot of people today that were just not understanding around them. Like, on the...
Okay, action Henry's take. Henry, what did you think? What was your favorite ride today?
Hagrid's. Yeah, Hagrid's.
Motorbike?
Yeah. Hagrid's motorbike, so it's fast, it's crazy.
It goes backwards?
It goes backwards, and it's like, if you've ever been to Disney and, the Mount Everest one, it literally, yeah, and this is a little bit crazier.
It's way more intense than Everest.
Yeah, you go really fast. It's like any kind of motorcycle. You kind of go little, just normal fast at first, like any other roller coaster. But then you like speed up. It's probably, Dad, would you say it's as fast as the Velocicoaster?
No.
Okay.
Definitely not.
How about Hulk? They look faster.
But it's probably faster than Hulk. Yeah.
It's a little faster than Hulk. Yeah.
So would you recommend that for other 10-year-olds?
Yeah.
Do you think a 7-year-old could do it?
Yeah.
If they were tall enough?
Yeah, if you were tall enough.
Okay.
Any other questions?
What was your second favorite ride?
Forbidden Journey. I like the way we move. The way how some of it's real and some of it's 3D. Because if it was all 3D, I wouldn't even be mentioning it. But some of it's like real life. And I forgot to mention this, but the other day, we got delayed in the tree part when we were leaning back. Our theme was like completely like this. It was like tilted. Like,
yeah. We literally stopped right as we were like the furthest lean back as we could go. And the ride breaks down.
Yeah, and it's really realistic, really cool. Mentor part's crazy. The only part I don't like is the dragon part when smoke comes out of his mouth, it is hot. And I just don't like it. And it gets in my eyes. The Forbidden Forest is crazy. But yeah, I think Forbidden Journey is easily second.
Okay. Would you recommend the Seuss rides for little kids?
Is that even a question?
Obviously. It was clearly a question.
It's a little kid's area. I mean, if you're older and you just want to relax for not even a minute, the trolley thing where you go up is not even a minute.
Well, there was a little girl behind us who was about 4, and she was like, this is a cool ride. So I think if you were 4, you'd enjoy that.
Yeah. If you were any years older, I mean, well, if you were way older, then definitely not. You'd feel like you were on a board train. And Ken Hat, 5 or younger. If you're 6 riding that, I really don't care. If you're 7 riding that and you like it a lot, I don't know what to say about you.
Now everyone has different tastes, different
likes. Yeah, whatever.
After the Harry Potter rides, what would you say was your next favorite?
I should have rolled Hulk. That would have probably been my favorite. I don't know what I did. I suggested it. It looks sweet. I almost wrote it. I freaked out, panicked. And I don't know if I saw it. But, I'm not gonna say anything I haven't wrote. But that would probably, I actually like the Jimmy Fallon race for New York. That's cool. Spider-Man's probably, Spider-Man most likely.
What about Simpsons? You like that one too?
Yeah, I like the Simpsons a lot. The only problem with it is, it's 3D. It's like, well, and if you look to your left, you can see other things. So.
Okay. Well, those are some pretty good segments of Henry's take. Good opinions. What? You got one more?
One more question.
what would you recommend if you like Harry Potter a lot? What would you recommend doing other than the ride?
Good question. They have those light shows. You might have saw that earlier. Those are cool. Those are really nice. Butterbeer. Don't get it cold. If you get a cold, I don't know what. I don't really know.
The hot butterbeer?
Yeah. I love the hot butterbeer.
The wand experience?
Getting a wand from Ollivander's. Now, you have two options. I'm going to tell you which one you probably should do. The experience goes through a room, or it's like in the movie. There's a bit of a line. And the normal way, you can just go in the store and get something and pay it for it and get out. Now, if you are running low on time, I suggest the second one I said, which is the boring kind of just go in there and get your wand. And if you want to have some fun, I would suggest going through experience. Now, if the line's forever, I mean, don't. Ollivander's cool. I would suggest, since this isn't a ride, technically, taking the train is funner, and it's quicker. The line could be crazy, but it's probably worth just doing. You might as well. I mean, if you're tired of walking, especially, and the seats are warmer.